Greetings, my friends, my brothers and sisters out there. I'd love to welcome you to a short presentation on how to preserve vitamin C from the lemons. I have a lot of lemons with me. I know that most of us are locked up in our houses and we are wondering how are we going to survive, especially that we have entered into the cold season. And vis-a-vis the current crisis of COVID-19, we are all scared to say, maybe I may develop a flu and you don't know whether it is COVID-19 or just a common cold. So I think as common sense tells us, vitamin C is a very critical vitamin, a very vital vitamin for us to survive various viral attacks, especially in the cold season. It helps in many ways to strengthen our immune system against viral attacks. And I know that some of us, or perhaps most of us, may not manage to go to the shops to buy the vitamin C complements or supplements. So what we need to do is, we have this super fruit. Most of us don't like lemons because of their sour taste. But never mind. This is a super fruit when it comes to the vitamin C. So I would love to show you how you can preserve this vitamin C and prepare it in a rather different way and preserve it, because sometimes lemons cannot be kept for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, they'll go bad. But there's a way in which you can preserve this for your family or for you as an individual, so that you can have extra source of vitamin C, especially as we have entered into the cold season. So come with me. I would love to prepare this and squeeze out the juice from these lemons, and thereafter you'll be able to follow what I'll be doing. So come with me. So I have already washed my hands, don't worry. I have to cut this and squeeze into the container. Make sure that the container is very clean. Don't use a dirty container which has bacteria or other things that may not make the juice more suitable for your family and for you as an individual. So I'm squeezing. I'm sorry, I don't have the squeezer. I think my wife didn't show me where to find the squeezer. I tried to search, I didn't find it. So I'm going to use just my hands and demonstrate. So we keep on squeezing and squeezing and squeezing and squeezing and squeezing until I finish all this. So please don't get tired. Don't get tired. Very soon I'm going to finish squeezing the lemons. Squeezing the lemons. That's the phase where we are. Squeezing the lemons. So please, if you're home and you have lemons nearby you, start squeezing like me. We want to preserve some natural vitamin C at home. Very cheap. And you don't need to spend any money. Just at home. This will be enough. And it will not just enhance your immune system against the virus, but there will be other benefits such as purifying your body. So come with me in the squeezing of the lemons. We continue with the squeezing. You see, I'm just remaining with two lemons right now. Squeeze the lemon. Squeeze. I hope you are squeezing at home. Make sure that there's enough juice. You see that this is natural juice. You need to drink, and you're going to have a good supply of vitamin C in your body. Squeeze. Just squeeze. And we are almost getting there with the squeezing of the juice. Squeeze with me. Don't stop squeezing until we finish. I'm remaining with only one lemon. Only one lemon remaining. Oh, look at that. Okay, we do that. It's an accident. Never mind. There we go. Uh-huh. Squeeze this also in so that we have as much juice as possible. Squeeze some more lemons in your container until there's enough for everyone to drink. And last but not the least, this is a super fruit when it comes to vitamin C. Super fruit. Very sour, but very rich. When it enters into your body, you're going to benefit. The body will enjoy. Squeeze. And I'm doing the last one. The squeezing is finally done. I wish I had a squeezer, and if you have a squeezer at home, actually there's so much that you can extract from the pills. You see, it's quite a great deal of pills, and I'm going to demonstrate how these can also be of value in the next session that we are going to do on vitamin C and other health related series. Okay, the squeezing is now done. Now, what next? Yes, so I'll get this plate and put it aside because the job is done now. I'll put the knife this side, and now we've got on my plate, small plate here, there are about 1, 2, 3, there are about seven cloves of garlic, and this is ginger, nicely prepared, and the peels are removed. And I also have the powdered version of ginger. It's very cheap. I think you can find it in a nearby shop. And then there's garlic powdered also. And I've got honey. You can add some honey. And there's plain malt. This is also very rich for your body, especially very rich in B12. Okay, so what you're going to do now is to enhance this plain juice. You can actually prepare it the way it is, but I think we need to spice it up so that we enhance the value. So what you're going to do is, with me, I have a blender here. I'm not an expert in using blender, so if I mess up, please bear with me. We are going to pour the juice into the blender. You pour the juice into the blender. There you go. Don't throw the seeds, please. Don't throw the seeds. In another lecture series, I'm going to present to you the value of seeds. And actually, when you read from the Bible, in Genesis, God gave humanity to subsist on fruits, nuts, and grains. So there's value in the lemon seed, which we are going to explain in another series, just on seeds. What seeds can add value to your body in such and such a way. That's what we are going to do. So don't worry about the seeds now, but I'll explain what value do we get from eating the lemon seeds, bitter though they might be. So you can see a smaller quantity of some lemon juice here. I think I extracted about half a liter. I'm not a good extractor, but if you had a lemon juice extractor, this should have been more than, maybe it could have been a liter. But this is okay for now. So after I put that into my blender, you come with me and get the garlic cloves. They are just 7 for now, but you can put more depending on how much you want in your body. This product is very good as it provides a very good supply of antioxidants in the body, which prevents free radicals. Free radicals are the ones that we are not as what? To get easily sick. But God does not want us to be sick, because in 3 John is telling us that he wants us to prosper and also to be in good health. So this is COVID-19 crisis period, and we have entered into the cold season where the flus and colds are so pronounced. What shall we do? We need to put in the body also, apart from the medicine and so on, we need to put in the body the right food so that that food may become the medicine. So come with me as we put the cloves. They have gone there, and we've got the ginger here. I think for the sake of ease of blending, I would love to slice it a bit into some pieces so that it will be very easy to do the blending. Okay, so we put it there. We're done with that phase, and now we go into the blending itself. You close and you turn on the knob to blend. So come with me as we do the blending. Very soon we are going to have a complete mix of the blended lemon juice, lemon seeds, garlic, and some ginger. Thank you. Great. I think the blending is now done, but we can do more. Now, in case you are not able to use this, I think what you're basically doing here is just to mix the garlic, the ginger, and the seeds to be crushed. In case you don't have the blender, we can always use a pounding mortar. You can find a pounding mortar and pound the ginger or the garlic and even the seeds. But if you don't have even the pounding mortar, you can use the powdered. That's why I came with this, so that I demonstrate. You shouldn't get stuck, because God has given us enough wisdom. So we can use powdered ginger and garlic. It's also going to add so much value. In fact, this one is more refined. And I'm going to add just a bit, so that we can enhance the content. Okay, there you go. That is a bit of ginger and a bit of powdered garlic. Also, it's going to add a lot of value. A little of powdered garlic. Mm-hmm. There you go. And back to the mixing. Yes, I think we are getting there. But there's one more thing that I want to demonstrate. You're aware that these green peels also are very rich in vitamin C? So we're going to just add one for the sake of demonstration. So in a situation where you really, really need a good supply, even these must be blended together. I need to be a bit more bitter, but I think it will be sweeter when it enters into the stomach. In fact, nutritionists say that most of the things which are bitter in the mouth are actually sweet for the digestive system. And those things which are very sweet in the mouth, in most, if not all cases, are very, 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 very bitter to the digestive system. So you're doing yourself a good favor and a good service to the digestive system. And when you serve it well, it will serve you better. So let's see if we add this one. So there we go. Just one. I think this will be enough, because if you put everything, it will be trouble to try to test this product. Let's go. Okay, there you go. You cannot see any trace of a lemon peel. Everything is crushed. Now, what do we do next? So we have blended the lemon juice, the seeds, garlic, ginger, and we have put one lemon peel. It's very bitter, but so we didn't put so much because nobody's gonna taste this. But if you manage, it will do a good favor when it enters into the system. So now, we know that this product is not really bitter. We can just say it's sour to some extent. So to enhance the taste and at least make it a bit more attractive, we are going to add a bit of, this is homemade Kabompo natural honey. Kabompo natural honey is homemade good honey. Honey is very good for your health. You should add it to your diet. Okay, so we're putting a bit of honey just to enhance the taste. Not too much. We are not putting so that it becomes sweeter. Just to enhance the taste, to try to neutralize that bitterness that comes with, especially a lemon peel. And with me, I have plain malt. Plain malt is also a very good product. It's more or less like molasses. I think you should know molasses is in that family. So we are putting just a bit of that. Okay, there you go. So it's just to enhance the flavor and the taste, so that it's not purely lemon. I know that some people may not like lemon naturally. So there you go. And we again do the blending so that we go into the final stage. Okay. You see that the color is even changed. Okay, I think this should be enough. So you see that it now looks brownish because you have put some lemon and the malt and so on and so forth. Don't put any natural flavors. You're going to destroy the value. So all the products you put here must be natural. Then you're going to enjoy the benefit of this product. So this is now a high concentration of vitamin C, and there's so many antioxidants and other food values that you find in Malta and also in honey. So what next is the next question. What you're going to do is to get this, you turn off and, oh, this is hard. Okay, great. You turn off and remove the lid, put it aside. And now it's time for us to actually, can, if you don't have an extra container, it's okay. You can pour direct into the tray, but we are going to put it in here. There you go. Okay, so this is a high concentration. No water must be added. High concentration of vitamin. Okay, so I'm pretty sure that you know the name. You can guess the name of this. Eh? It's not an egg tray. It is ice cube tray. And you know, I think to mothers and even any other person, this tray is most often very popular. During which season? Very hot season. Because we want to put some ice here so that when you're drinking water, it's a bit chilled. But it can also be used in cold season. In cold season, this tray is very unpopular. But this is how you can make it popular. As we are trying to promote the preservation of vitamin C at home, instead of keeping lemons that are going to just be thrown away as waste, we can preserve this and even save your money. You know, money is not easy to come by, especially in this current situation. So this can help you to be more economic. So now is to pour into each and every section. There you go. We are filling up, filling up, filling up, filling up, filling up, filling up. And there you go. It's like it was a well-calculated measurement. I didn't know that it would be exactly the size of the ice cube tray. Look at that. Okay? So we have done the filling, and there are a bit of particles inside here. It's not pure liquid, and that is very good because you need to have everything taken into your system. There is a lemon peel here, there's garlic, there's ginger, there's some honey and malta, and then the juice itself. But the juice is the main content. So we are able to now take this to the freezer. That's where you're gonna take. I would love to most sincerely apologize for those who may not have access to a fridge, but you know, we need to be social beings. If you have no fridge, I think you should have some neighbor who can assist you, and you can actually attract them by saying, I want to show you how to make this, and in the process you're also going to actually benefit. So ensure that you put this in the deep freezer. So it's time for deep freezing. See you soon. Welcome back. Our concentrated vitamin C has just solidified. You see, we're able to do like that. This is how it looks like in the ice cube tray. So you have just preserved vitamin C just from your backyard. You get the lemons, squeeze them and mix them with some other natural products, and you are able to preserve the vitamin C for this cold season. And I would love to taste one, just a cube. Okay, there you go. It's coming out very well. It's coming out very well. Get a knife. And you get a cube. Have you seen? There it is. Looks like beautiful sweet, eh? Just like that. Just like that. So instead of using candies, you can use this natural ice cube of concentrated lemon and other products that you saw me putting into the product. And I think I need to put this aside. Okay, so with me, I have a cube on my small plate here, so I can use a knife to get Ah, it's like this, eh?
Yeah. You see that?
Uh-huh. It is breaking. Quite more friendly. It's not as hard as pure water because of those particles, eh? You see, so I have this particle of concentrated lemon, concentrated vitamin C, and I can chew it. Perfect. Yeah, so apart from chewing the ice of lemon juice, you can also get a glass of water. If you don't want so much of the sour taste of a lemon, but it's nice, very nice actually, to just take the ice itself. So refreshing and so enriching to your body. Then you throw it in your water. You allow for some defrosting to take place, and you can be taking slowly. And there you go. Very nice, and it's going to enrich you with some vitamin C to enhance your immune system, especially as we are in the cold season. You need a lot of vitamin C in order to fight all these viral diseases. We are not saying that this is going to cure your flu or your cough, but it's going to increase your fighting ability against the viral attacks. And all of us are now locked up in our homes, and you'd want to figure out how are you going to have enough intake of vitamin C. This could be one of the strategies that you can use. It's very cheap and very affordable, and I think this option is good, for example, for someone who may not have a deep freezer. You just take the liquid, just after blending you can take it the way it is as a liquid. But the problem with that is you have to use it at once because you may not have where to preserve it. But with this in place, there's a deep freezer somewhere, you can keep this for quite some days. I think even a month you can keep without losing any special supply of vitamin C. So let me finish up. Perfect. I have this and I have to take it back for tomorrow. So I hope that you have learned something on how we can preserve vitamin C at home from the lemon juice, including the seeds. I think I promised that I'm going to explain something about the seeds themselves. What are the values of taking in the seeds within our bodies? So we would love to most sincerely appreciate your coming, and please make a date for another series on health presentation. You need to be healthy in all things so that you prosper and enjoy your hard work. Thank you very much, and God bless.